Good morning. Okay, so today we'll speak about open innovation and the security and sharing the data information for say a better awareness in the field of cybersecurity vertical. Orange Romania is in the second year partner with DEFCAM. So we started last year with the bug bounty up to own contest. This year is the second challenge. I will start by introducing you some data which are coming from the CERT RO. It's a statistics from the last 3 years with the evolution of the total number of security alerts. We can see that from 2013 to 2014 it was an increase, almost double, and then a small drop, probably because of the patching on the Windows systems and some other say updates. In the left corner you will see the top 5 affected systems and the top 5 security alerts by incident. More details about these reports, for this more information I will advise you to go directly on the CERT RO website and to download the reports are both in Romanian and in English, with a lot of information, helpful information about the number of scanned domains, the alerts, the type of the alerts, the methodology behind, and also plenty of suggestions, guidelines, recommendations from the CERT. Now, seeing all that risk and the attacks and the information coming from the security field, from the risk coming from the Romanian online ecosystem, Orange started to think about introducing a product and a service and a platform on the security on the cybersecurity field, and the process actually started long time ago. So we are a corporation. We are thinking in more steps, and this just to give you a hint about our internal process in designing a service. Particularly in this case, we speak about the business internet security, which started in H1 2014 with assessment, opportunity assessment, marketing assessment, then going on with the request for quotation. So in our say corporation, this is the traditional bid process in which you are inviting several vendors on the market, so well-known vendors, and then you are playing with them in terms of trials, proof of concepts, specifications, hundreds of pages of technical requirements, services, and so on. For sure that then you need to validate it on the field, and we went directly to the customers, to our let's say best customers, asking them if they are accepting to do a kind of friendly user trial with different solutions, and they help us to select the best offer. We ended this process in end of 2014 with selecting Fortinet for the MSSP service, and starting from that we did the build part, the migration of the old old customers from old infrastructure to the new one, and then we went directly last year in the bug bounty before to put additional customers, just to test and to improve the capability of the platform and to let's say to share the knowledge with the participant from the DEFCAM. After that, we put in place a security operational center with our partners, and again, the service was let's say commercially available starting from this year, 4th April, and since then we are improving the capabilities for our platform and also for our services, for our professional services, bringing new partners in the let's say the penetration test, vulnerability assessment type of services. We are doing the additional development, the fine-tuning of the platform based on the results we get back, and we are continuing the bug bounty programs, including this year with this year bug bounty contest. So just few snapshots from our let's say protected customers. And here we are speaking about different organizations from public sectors, from private sectors. Here you have some nice statistics. So you know that the school started earlier this year with a couple of days, so an increase in traffic we can see in the left corner. But unfortunately, still problems on the education sector with Zeus, with TOFC initiators. So practically the type of the vulnerabilities which actually we know there are patching since 8 years, 9 years. Also there are problems with and for sure that we are blocking this. We are discussing with the information security administrators. This is again from the education sector. To not allow the students to go on a pornography site or on the e-auction site during the school period. Also in the public sector, we are also seeing the same, let's say, habits. And all in the healthcare sector, some snapshots highlighting the problem with the type of the devices they are using for accessing the internet. For example, the Link, Asus, and Netcore, the red in the right part, actually are saying that okay, they are using some cheap stuff to use to access the internet, some wireless cheap stuff, which are having the pass hard coded and easy to be scanned and a lot of vulnerabilities behind. We are advising them, we are giving reports, we are giving additional suggestions to change their equipment, to patch their systems, for sure that the policy on our systems are updated, but this is pretty much the situation. I mentioned the professional services. We are working now with Romanian companies, some of them big companies, some others are startups. BitSentinel, it's one of them. Cyber Smart Defense is another one. We have also NSSEC with us. So the target for us is to try to create more awareness in the organization sector and to show that, okay, having a solution, having a system, having a machine to protect the infrastructure, it's maybe not enough. You need also to have some more eyes, and also to have some more eyes which are conducting, let's say, manual type of benchmarks. And here our approach is not a reactive one, it's a proactive, trying to provide the information before the actually attack will happen. And the question for us, why let only a machine fight against the real human's mind? So we are using the power of the small companies doing this kind of penetration test to help our customers, our organization, to improve their system, their infrastructure, and to be aware about the risk. Following the same concept, we developed together with BitSentinel the threat map, so you can see it also in our stand. You also see it if you've been yesterday during the lunch, during the welcome speech of our CTO. So it's again about awareness. It's practically collecting the information, anonymized information, from all our sensors deployed in Romania, in the organization that we are protecting. And it's showing in a real-time manner the vulnerabilities, the risks, the threats with different statistics. And and we also have in plan some additional functionalities. For example, what we are going to introduce, just to be more efficient for different verticals. I mentioned the education, the public sector, I mentioned the healthcare, we have retail, transport, and so on. So what we want to do is to, in the next version that will come in the next month, we are going to introduce per vertical the statistics and the information. Just to be very simple, if somebody from, another high school or from university would like to see what is the risk on his segment, just he will see the particularly the information coming from the education sector. What we did more, so again, we are here in the second year, and we are encouraging this vulnerability disclosure under the framework of the Bug Bounty program, so Optimum Bug Bounty. For us, it's very important, like I mentioned, to improve, to patch, and to use the collective information and the collective skills of you, of the professional in the cybersecurity, to help us to improve the infrastructure. Also, we are supporting and sustaining the different competitions, like the one mentioned here, Europe Cybersecurity Challenge. And 2 days ago, the Romanian national teams managed to be in the second position from the top 10 countries in Europe during this competition, which is a yearly competition. It was a great success, especially that last year we came on the fifth place, and in front of us last year we had Germany, Austria, and Switzerland, and now actually we managed to came second after Spain. So it was a difficult, a hard contest, and here you can see some pictures from the during the day of the competition. So 2 days ago was the final. We had also a national qualification during the autumn. The partners in this contest were CyberInt, Bitdefender, Microsoft, and ANSSEI, and Dell, and also CERT, a part of Orange. Here you can see the last, the scoring board after the final probe from two days ago. You can see Romania coming on the second after Spain. Different challenges, pawn, acknowledgement, geopardic, code patching, defense, attack, and availability. And it was also a last challenge, which actually one member of the team, so that each team is composed of 10 participants, high school and university, so mixed, one member of each team had to present one of the challenge during a 6 minutes presentation. And on that last challenge, Romania managed to came on the first position, just to preserve the second position overall. So this is the winning team. Probably you'll hear more about this from news in the couple of days, in the next days. Coming back to the threat map. So it was very important for us, and the feedback that we get from the market, from our partners, from our customers, is that we are on the right track, we are on the good direction. And this is the reason that now we started to think about, okay, why not sharing the information? Why not gathering additional information from the same field, so real-time logs from organizations that are thinking in the same way like us? These are some snapshots from yesterday. I just took some pictures last evening. It's a public site. You can check it from different mobile or fixed terminals. So companies with security incidents detected last 24 hours. So this was yesterday. Nice statistics. So Conficker seems to be still in the news, and like also the others, Loki and Tofsi. Intrusion attempts. I mentioned the slide in which I discussed about the vulnerabilities on the Wi-Fi access points, or so the chief Wi-Fi access points, or so NetCore, NetEase. It's 20% from all the intrusion attempts last 24 hours. The company with security incidents detected. Again, these are coming from all the all the organizations, or so the sensors that we are operating in Romania. So it's nationwide. Coming back to the bounty program. So why we are doing this, and why we are still continuing to? So it's clear that for us it's a benefit for us as Orange, because we are improving our infrastructure that is used for our customer, for our organization. And this is our direction. So the direction that we established 1 year and a half ago. And it seems that still we are the only one doing this. Probably other organizations, other operators are not prepared or not thinking the same direction. But still, the feedback we get, I mentioned the feedback we get from our customers or from our partners is practically confirming the rationale behind. And what is also nice, that worldwide top companies are still doing the same. So it's not that Orange invented this this type of contest. There are big companies, really big companies, doing this. And these figures are from yesterday. Worldwide, 32,000 bug fixed, 156 public programs, and it's counting. It's you have the link if you want to check it. So each day you will see that these figures are increasing. So it's something which is happening anyway. Our competition, so it's also based on some fair guidelines, fair rules. Started on 31st October, we had an online period, and now we are on the, let's say, on-site period, but still it's an online contest, because the infrastructure, it's in, you will see the diagram. It was the registration, so the team from DEFCON did a good job, excellent job, to help us with all the logistics, all the registration process, the validation of the reports, and the scoring board. So the contest will end tomorrow, when we also have the award ceremony. In terms of responsible disclosure, for sure that we are providing points and the vulnerability risk you managed to exploit. The DOS is not accepted, and so on. So there are some, like I said, some fair rules that a participant needs to respect. And it's not so complicated. So innovative methods will get extra points, and we receive a lot of reports with innovative ways of, let's say, penetrating the infrastructure. This is the architecture behind. It's a real life architecture. It's not something which is emulating a real life. It's an architecture that the engineering team, together with our partners, so the engineering team from Orange Romania, and here we have the leader of engineering team, Horia, did a good job. So practically we had two nodes. You'll see node one and node two, because I'm going to enter in the statistics after this. So they are deployed in different parts of Romania in our data centers. It's a hardware appliances. You have the vulnerability server, which is managed by DEFCON, installed on a VM, also in our data centers. And between these you have the IP network, so the MPLS network of Orange Romania, and for sure then the internet used for the participants to exploit to attack the server, the vulnerability server. In terms of the profiles on the WAF and on the firewall, we said that okay, let's start with a with a simple profile, with a low security profile, and then to change it on a high security profile. This is just for the online phase, and then we are doing the same for the on-site phase. We had the variation just to cover all the, let's say, the needs and all the capabilities and all the expectations from the participants. So today, now we are on the since last night, we are on the high security profile, and this is going to finish at 4 o'clock. I mentioned when we will announce the winners of the contest, and we will we have the ceremony in the Hacking Village section. What means low security profile? So basic default signature. You have here all the classes. So practically, the low security profiles, it's something which should not pose too many problems to an experimented ethical hacker. And then we added the additional protection, so custom policies on top of the previous one for a high security profile. And basically we changed these two profiles. In terms of scoring, we kept the same scoring board from last year competition, but with the low in the case of the low security profiles, actually the scoring is 40% from these figures here. For the high security profile is 100%. We had until yesterday at 6 o'clock p.m. 58 registered people, 8 participants scored, 68 received reports, so validated reports, 48 validated reports, and around 3,000 something granted points. And it's important, because actually we saw in the reports, I'm not going to enter in the reports, we will see from the machine point of view what we saw, because the reports will be analyzed now. Actually, we started to analyze now together with the partners, and to split them in the configuration problems, so the updates on the configuration, and the problems on the or patching that we need to do on the machines. Some nice statistics. Part of the 10 countries that so we have participants from 10 countries. In terms of age, it's a pretty fair distribution, so very interesting. Also in terms of gender, maybe a surprise, at least for me, it was a surprise, so 45% female. Going on the machine side, so on the 40 web, so the WAF part, the statistics on the low. So we started with the low and then we moved to the high. So the statistics are until yesterday, 6 o'clock. So it was, I mentioned node 1 and node 2 on each of the profiles. If you count, if you add the total number of top attacks by date, you will see probably around 50,000 on the low SEC profile. But on the high SEC profiles, it was only, so we counted only 2,000 more or less. This was only for the, until yesterday. Going more on the in the distribution of the attack by dates. So in the low security profile on the two nodes, it was more on the 3rd and the 4th of June, so of November. Moving on the high security profile when it was a fair distribution. In terms of the top attack sources, so I don't know if you recognize some of the IPs here. Top attack types. Signature for web servers on the high profiles, on the low profiles. This is the most, let's say, used. SQL injection and so on, so the pretty basic stuff. In the FortiGate part, top users by reputation, intrusion by timeline, so a lot of statistics. In top intrusion by type, so SQL injection and so on, and only SQL injection in the high security profile, more type of intrusion types, more types of intrusion in the low profile. A part of the contest, we also did something else just to create more awareness. You know that here the internet, the connection, it's assured by Orange, so it's both wireless and cabled internet connection for the Hacking Village. We had three networks, so DEFCOM CTF, DEFCOM Wire Station, and DEFCOM Free Wi-Fi. The total bandwidth in the first day, it's around 143 gigabytes. So it's quite impressive comparing with what we know from the hotspots that we are operating. Vlad mentioned yesterday some statistics about terabytes and so on in one day from all our Wi-Fi operated hotspots. Intrusion by severity. The split between medium, high, low, and critical. Intrusion by type, so information disclosure, SQL injection. This is, again, in all the conference, in all the three rooms during the first day of the conference. Then, intrusion sources. So, somebody tried a lot to do something, 46%. Congrats for this. I don't know if this guy is in the room, but it seems that did a good job. Then, malware detected. Zeus, 35 counts. Victim. If it's here, again, congrats also for this guy. I don't know if he's the company, laptops, or... Okay, so again, this is just for the first day. We are going to also to explore for the second day, and then we are going to do a sum up, and probably we will share all the information with you on different channels. Botnets detected and that botnets victims. Also in our stand, you have we invited our partners TechLunch with the Innovation Labs. I also discussed last year. I introduced the Innovation Labs, which is our pre-accelerator program, a startup program, which it's running each year between February and end of May. And for us, it's very important because we are a part of the, let's say, the nice products that and the teams that are formed there. We have a pretty interest in terms of the tracks, and we are actually trying to define 1 year before the tracks together with the partners to be somehow aligned with what is Orange seeing in the vertical, in the different industries. And for the next year, we prepare, and this is the first time that we are introducing this information for the next year Innovation Labs. It will be under the umbrella of smart territories. Why smart territories? Because we are thinking that, okay, a part of the smart city that since 1 year we started a lot to discuss about and to bring solution on the market together with partners, together with the startups. We also have the cybersecurity track and call. We also had it this year, and also the retail, agriculture, and lifestyle. We will particularly focus on the cybersecurity And just an idea, this year on the health and lifestyle, we managed to select, to recruit from this program a company, a startup, which is working with us in this moment for a smart city product that we just launched on the market. And also on the retail, we selected 2 years ago, so in 2014, when we actually started this program to participate in this program, we recruited a company, a startup in that time from Bucharest, which with which we developed a product on the retail. It's called Retail Business Analytics, and I guess Vlad mentioned it yesterday. And the company is actually now growing, and it's helping us to provide a targeted solution, analytic solution for retail. And now we moved with that product also to smart cities to do an city analytics in the places in which we are installing the outdoor Wi-Fi hotspots. So coming back to the cybersecurity part and to the innovation labs for the next year. This is the basic agenda. We will start with a hackathon in Alba Iulia. Why Alba Iulia? Because I mentioned the smart city. Alba Iulia, it's one of our pilot places in which we are deploying all our smart city infrastructure, and we are opening the infrastructure. All the API is there, and here we are speaking about different stuff from the radio part, sensors, IoT type of applications, industrial applications, metering, and we are looking for developers, and this is a place to raise this this call. Then we will have the hackathon. So the hackathon is the opening event. Event is the 24-hour coding weekend with another 24-hour for pitching. So it will be Bucharest and then Cluj-Napoca, Iași and Timișoara. So five cities. Then between the hackathons and the demo day, which will be, I mentioned, end of May, there will be plenty of activities in terms of mentoring, product testing, proof of life, proof of so demos on the real lives and the development of the teams and of the products. And we said, okay, let's do also, let's continue the bug bounty programs. Let's continue what we started last year with a ransomware challenge. So it's a pretty new contest in the same framework. And we said, okay, let's start it somewhere in February, just to finish in time for the Bucharest Hackathon. And together with our colleagues from Innovation Labs, so TechLunch, and with DevCamp, we will try to manage this in such a way to finish in 2 weeks with the contest and to have the award ceremony during the hackathon in on 4th and 5th March. What means ransomware challenge? We want to emulate a real situation. A company with a large corporation with an HR department receiving a lot of applications, CVs and other documents. And we'll try to emulate, again, here the team of DevCamp that help us with bug bounty. They will also help us with this logistics. We will emulate this, and the people from the HR will actually click on all the attachment, and you know actually what happens. And the challenge is to encrypt some files and to ask for ransom and to prove that encryption. So now we are working on the details for the platforms, extra points if you can encrypt the files with preventive measures implemented from at least one solution. We will have a minimum of two solutions that we will try to we will bring in the pictures, because again it's about testing an infrastructure. It's about testing sandboxing technology from different vendors. So according to security level will be more than one mailbox, so each will increase the level of protection and difficulty. If you target one mailbox, you will receive some points. If you target more, you will increase your chance to win. And we will keep the same responsible disclosure policy. So the contest will run for 2 weeks, I mentioned. It will be an online. Pretty much around 13th and 25th February, and the last the day in which we will announce the winners will be during the hackathon in Bucharest, which is will be in the weekend of 4th and 5th March. So for more information, details and policies, I'll kindly advise you to watch, to follow the DevCamp website and also Innovation Labs site. We'll also come with information on different other channels. Some points at the end to take away. So for us, what I mentioned before, so the security audits and penetration tests should be a continuous process, a business as usual process, a recurrent one. I mentioned that we are looking startups, local innovators for public data and public data sets providers to help us to improve, to extend the smart cities ecosystems, and the same way it's applied to the threat map. Having this concept in mind of open innovation and data sharing, I mentioned that we are also looking the peers like us, thinking the same, with the same, let's say, vision, to try to increase the awareness in the organization. It's important also the team behind, and this is basically the idea, the three programs that, and the two programs and the maps. Again, I invite you in the stand, in our stand, for more information. We also have a huge team here from different departments, IT departments, because we are also presenting our way of developing the internal applications, our way of working with external developers and startups. We also have the Innovation Labs and our partners, TechLunch, which is together with us in the stand. And you can also see and play with the threat map and different other points here. So I will take the questions now. So smart questions will be awarded with some nice